Ladies and gentlemen, just as has been said, I'll do two things in one session. I'll give some vote of thanks and then I'll give a few remarks as we end this workshop. First of all, being a Kenyan, we usually start with thanking our hosts. We ask thanking ourselves. And so I'm taking this advantage to actually appreciate the Vice Chancellor, Professor Wainaina, for actually even approving this workshop to be held here. It's not a must that when a request has been made, it has to be accepted. So when it is accepted, we feel greatly honored for the same. And of course, he works with a board of management, which also approves the same. And so we are extending the thanks for the same. We also wish to thank the Gateways in Africa team under the leadership of Professor Simon Taylor, project coordinator from Brunel University, UK. I think we need to appreciate him with a clap. We also had the technical coordinator of the University of Catania University, Professor Roberto Barbera. Clap for him. Thank you very much. We also wish to thank Dr. Kanyaru from Wolverhampton University, specifically for recommending this workshop to be held in KU. We feel honored for that. I think I saw you at the end there. Yes, thank you. We also wish to thank the keynote speaker, Professor Wagasha from the University of Nairobi. Now, we had other invited speakers from ICT, National Transport and Safety Authority, and they were not able to be with us, but at least we had a representation from the Minister of Health on behalf of the DMS, Mr. Kamau, and we also appreciate the presence of the Kenneth team in this workshop. We appreciate them, of course, with a clap. Thank you for that. Then, of course, we are participants and we cannot go without appreciating ourselves, both the ones who are local and those from outside the boundaries of Kenya. We appreciate your presence and we can give you a clap for the same. And we know this workshop could not probably have proceeded without the organizing committee led by Dr. Maina and his group. We appreciate their hard work. We are in a place we are calling Kenyatta University Conference Center. I think they have been kind enough in their hospitality, etc. We need also to appreciate that hospitality. Having said that, I am planning not to thank myself, but just to go and give a few remarks as we close this workshop. So, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to be with you at the close of the workshop, which has just come to an end. The workshop becomes more important as it touched on human health, which is a precious commodity. You wait until you are dead is when you realize how important health is. The workshop brought afloat the missing link between science and diagnosis and clinical management of human diseases. And I do believe this is what has been going on through your times here. The ability of technology, as has always said very often, to solve public health problem can no longer be ignored. So this is an evolving thing, and I think I do hope that what has gone on today really contributes to that statement. The aim of creating awareness of open science gateways and promoting the exploitation of e-infrastructures to drive acquisition of universal health is very welcome. And I do believe this is what we are all trying to do. It is noted in the workshop, ladies and gentlemen, that wonderful systems have been developed, but there seems to be a disconnect in their usage. And this leads to unsustainable projects that are usually economically non-viable. You start a project, then because of non-sustainability, then non-viability, then it diminishes. There is then an urgent need for a common platform which can be shared. The platform, however, has to be friendly and easily and freely accessible at all levels. And I think this is where we usually fail. We have them, we cannot access them, either through technology or through finances. And of course, the E is part of it. We have been, you must have been discussing about the same. The human race has become digital, and it would not be difficult to get the intended information. These days, if you go to the very remote areas of the Kenya I know, you'll find very many persons with the smartphones, and they can do a lot with the same. So then, open science gateways in Africa becomes a very welcome venture. It will increase access to healthcare for many who have no opportunity. In all this, there is need for teamwork where competencies can be shared and thus creating synergies. Scientists must sacrifice their data and innovations to help the suffering of human beings. So this is shared information which the few minutes have been there, I could hear, you know, passing around that. We have a lot of information which we probably need to share with other persons. And of course, I am a researcher, and I know sometimes I have a lot of information in my drawer which has not been translated into any policy or anything that can help my neighbor where I stay. But I think this is an awakening call that should not be the case, that we need to create platforms where all this can be shared. I note, ladies and gentlemen, that you had an open discussion on how science gateway in Africa can support open science in Kenya. And I do believe that you made recommendations and resolutions that will achieve just that. And it's now my great pleasure in declaring this workshop formally closed. Thank you.